types and components of wind turbine operation. Most of us learned some ideas about wind turbine, but we need to review our past learning and add more information. The Knowledge Link Information Channel create this video to introduce the ideas or information of the different types and components of wind turbine operation. This video shows us about wind formation, wind power, and wind turbine. Wind formation. Wind is a natural movement of air or other gases in the planet's surface. Wind occur on range from light breeze to natural hazard like tornadoes, hurricanes, typhoons, and others. You cannot see the wind or even cannot hold it, but you can feel its force. Wind is strong enough to fly the airplane, to rotate any wind turbine or windmill, to move sailing ships across the ocean, and rip a huge trees from the ground. This wind also equalizes atmosphere and transport heat, moisture, pollutants, or dust in long distances around the globe. Wind movement in horizontal direction is much stronger than vertical direction. Anemometers is the instrument for measuring wind speed, while weather vanes and wind sucks pivot to indicate wind direction. Wind direction is a term of origin and blowing direction, such as northerly wind blows from north to south, easterly wind blows from northeast or southeast, westerly wind blows from west to east. Wind measurement is also described in terms of speed and direction. Wind caused by a combination of three concurrent events. Number one, the sun unevenly hit on the atmosphere and Earth surface. The atmosphere of the Earth have a constant motion of a gas layer that make up the air. Air mass is described by its properties such as pressure, density, temperature, and movement. The movement of air masses above the Earth's surface help to create a wind flow, while on same time, this wind helps the shape of atmosphere to show weather pattern. Wind is also an atmospheric phenomenon due to uneven sun heating. Wind is created from the difference of atmospheric pressure, which is mainly caused by temperature difference due to sun uneven heating in the atmosphere. Air moves from a higher to a lower pressure area that makes a various speed of wind blows during atmospheric pressure difference. The strength of the wind is determined by the distance between the two air pressure system and the difference of air pressure strength. The closer air pressure system are the stronger wind blows, while the farther apart are the weaker wind blows. Remember that hot air rises on atmosphere and cold air sink down to Earth's surface. That brings a difference of atmospheric pressure, which caused by uneven heating. Generally, Wind is created by the high pressure cold air flow. Quickly to fill up the space, wind low pressure warm air rises in the atmosphere. For example, the air above land warms faster than air over ocean water. Then, the cold ocean breeze created by cold air over ocean rises fill in the space when hot air over land rises. Land breeze occurs during nighttime when the land cold faster than sea. The air above water surface is warm and rises to pull cold air from land surface during nighttime. Number 2. The Earth rotation. The rotation of the planet is another major cause of air movement that create wind flows. Air will also deflected by the Coriolis effect during a rotation of the planet. The Coriolis effect causes wind to appear and deflect at the right of northern hemisphere or at the left of southern hemisphere. This Coriolis effect causes some winds to travel the edges of the high pressure and low pressure system that known as geostrophic winds. The Coriolis effect is also an important force to be considered for global weather patterns. Number 3. Irregularities of the Earth's surface. Many things on the Earth's surface that interfere the wind to slow down and change direction, like mountains, trees, buildings, lakes, and other surface irregularities. In mountainous parts of the Earth's surface have a relatively consistent wind that was passing through mountains with inconsiderable speed. The interruption of environmental wind flow circulation between mountains and valley are the most important contributor of the prevailing wind. Mountains, hills, and valleys distorted the airflow by increasing friction between atmosphere and landmass due to physical block of airflow. Wind direction also changes due to the contour of the land. Wind that flow over mountains down into lower elevation are called downslope wind. Cold winds accelerate through mountain gaps, and downwind airflow can be remain erratic or turbulent in some flat countryside, which is dangerous condition for descending or ascending airplanes. Wind blows over open water will also increase the mixing of the ocean upper layer that elevates cold, nutrient-rich water, which lead to increased marine life. Wind have 6 different types. Number 1. Monsoon winds are wind last on many months in the tropical region. This is a seasonal wind in Asia that blew from southeast during summertime or from northeast in wintertime. Number 2. Local wind are sea breeze, land breeze, mountain breeze, and valley breeze. This is an ordinary wind which is a part of daily weather. These local winds can be ranged from mild to strong in just few hours at short distance blowing. This type of wind influenced by various landforms like hill, plain, mountain, and vegetation. Number 3. Trade winds are the prevailing easterly winds that blow from west to east in tropics north and south of the equator. The trade wind in warm water of tropics are also responsible for the formation of tropical storms, cyclones, hurricanes, and typhoons. Number 4. Doldrums occur due to the constant sun radiation. It is a belt calm or light winds between the northern and southern trade winds in the Pacific and Atlantic. This type of wind occurs in a very low pressure area around the Earth equator, on where the prevailing winds are calm. Number 5. Polar Easterlies are cold and dry wind that originate from the high pressure regions, which is found around the North and South Pole. These polar easterlies are also known as polar Hadley cells. The polar easterlies are generally weak and irregular that blow from east to west. Number 6. The westerlies are strong winds blow from west to east and play a vital role in pushing equator warm water to the western continents. These westerlies are most powerful during winter time when pressure is lower over the poles, and weakest during summertime when pressure over the pole is higher. Wind power. Wind power or wind energy is the process on which wind used to generate mechanical power like electric generator, grinding grain, and pumping water. The term windmill is different from wind turbine. A windmill is commonly used for pumping water and grinding grains. The windmill will not produce electricity unless you attach a turbine generator to become a wind turbine. Wind power system is one of the growing renewable energy and continue to grow throughout the world. This wind power generation is free, clean, and abundant renewable energy source to power our world in sustainable manner. Human used wind power 4,000 years ago until now. It is an emission-free and renewable energy source that create a carbon-free in the future. Wind power or wind energy is the most economical renewable energy based on technological development. Because wind is free, that makes operational cost almost zero once a turbine was erected. The advantages of using wind power or wind energy. Number 1. Wind power is a clean fuel source. Wind energy do not pollute the air and do not produce atmospheric emission that cause smog, rain, or greenhouse gases. Using wind power is safe methods because it will not rely on combustion of fossil fuels like natural gas or coal that can emit sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide, which is harmful to human health. Wind power also helps some countries to meet their emission reduction programs and climatic changes. Number 2. Wind power is sustainable. The wind is a form of solar energy because it is created by sun and even heating on the planet's surface. The wind blows always as long as the sun shining. The use of wind to capture power does not deplete our valuable natural resources because wind energy is abundant and always available. Number 3. Wind is a domestic source of energy. The world wind supply is inexhaustible and abundant or limitless resources for renewable power. Number 4. wind energy is cost-effective. This is one of the lowest-priced energy sources for land-based utility because wind is fuel-free. Number 5. Any wind turbine can be built on existing ranches or farm. Wind turbine installed on existing ranches or farm cannot affect the farmers and ranches job because turbine used only a fraction of land. We have also some disadvantages of using wind power. Number 1. Wind turbine blades produce noise and can affect a visual impacts in the landscape view. Number 2. Some selected areas that good in land-based wind site are located in remote areas which is far from cities and needs a long-distance transmission line to send the electricity. Number 3. Spinning wind turbine blade can kill flying birds, bats, and other aerial wildlife. Wind turbine. Wind turbine create electricity by converting kinetic energy to electrical energy. Wind turbines followed after the invention of electric generator in year 1830, on which engineers tried to harness wind energy to produce electricity. The transformation of electrical energy using a wind turbines can be known also as wind energy conversion system. The wind heats a turbine blade that goes to rotate the turbine shaft, which is connected to generator and produce electrical energy through electromagnetism. The amount of electrical power that can be harvested from a wind depends on the length of blades and size of the turbines. Wind turbines are typically installed on hilltops or in coastal areas that have a stable and abundant wind flow. Remember that the 30 meters or higher from any obstruction of wind turbine tower are less turbulent, because wind speed increases with height. It is cheaper to build new wind farms than new gas or coal power plant, because our technology now develop a wind turbines to be more efficient and more robust. It means that technological development was made a wind turbine to produce more power, require less maintenance, and have a longer lifespan. We have some functional parts of commercial wind turbine that integrate the system of operation. Number 1. Brake. Necessary for maintenance that will keep the turbine blade to stop turning by means of controller stop mode. This brake keeps also the rotor from turning after it is shut down by the pitch system. Turbine brake system is different from car brake system. Number 2. Pitch system. Will adjust the angle of the wind turbine blade to control the rotor speed. The pitch system controls the energy of the wind extraction from blade by means of adjusting the turbine blade's angle. This pitch system has the function to feather the turbine blades when there is a strong wind, to slow down the turbine rotor for safe operation and prevent damage of the machine. Number 3. Yaw system. The yaw motor energizes the yaw drive and rotates the nozzle on upwind turbine type to keep the turbine blade facing on wind direction all the time. The downwind turbines type do not require a yaw drive because the wind blows manually the rotor away from it. Number 4. Nacelle. Contains a gearbox, generator, brake, low-speed shaft, and high-speed shaft. Number 5. Hub. This is one part of the turbine's drivetrain. The turbine blades attach into the hub, which is connected to the main shaft of the turbine. Number 6. Drivetrain. Composed of main bearing, rotor, gearbox, main shaft, and generator. This drivetrain converts the low speed in high torque rotation of the turbine rotor into electrical power. Number 7. Rotor is the assembly of blades and hub that connected together. Number 8. High speed shaft is a part of drivetrain that connected to the gearbox and drives of the generator. Number 9. Low speed shaft. It is also a part of the turbine drivetrain that connected to the rotor, on which spins only between 8 to 20 rotation per minute. Number 10. Main shaft bearing. Another part of turbine drivetrain that supports the low speed shaft not to damage from any forces of rotor. Number 11. Blade. The air pressure on one side of the blade decreases when the wind flows on the blade. The difference of air pressure across the two sides of the blade creates both lift and drag, in which lift force is stronger than drag that causes the rotor to spin. Number 12. Controller. Turns off the turbine during high wind speed to avoid damage of the turbine parts. This controller allows the turbine to start at wind speed about 7 to 11 miles per hour mph and shut off when wind exceed 55 to 65 mph. Number 13. Anemometer. Measure a wind speed and send the wind speed data to the controller. Number 14. Wind vane. Measure wind direction and communicates with yaw drive to orient the turbine position in respect to the wind direction. Number 15. Generator. Composed of copper winding that turn and create a magnetic field to produce electricity. This generator is driven by the high-speed shaft. Some generators in the wind turbine are driven by gearbox. Other wind turbine generators are direct drives, on which the rotor attached directly on generator. Components of commercial wind power distribution. Number 1. Transformer. Wind power plant use a step-up transformer to increase the voltage and decrease the power loss during voltage transmission on high current at long distance. The other step-down transformer reduce the voltage when it reach in community to make the electric power safe and usable by building or home equipments. Number 2. Transmission line. Carry electrical in high voltage at long distance from wind turbine to the areas of where energy is needed. Number 3. Substation. Links the transmission system to the distribution system when electricity delivers to community. The substation also contains a step-down transformer that converts a high voltage to lower voltage and delivers safely the electricity to consumers. The main types of wind turbines are the following. Number 1, HAWT wind turbines, horizontal axis wind turbine, are most commonly used due to their efficiency and strength. This is called horizontal axis because the rotating axis align horizontally. The tower base must be extremely strong because the rotor shaft was installed on the top of the tower, which allow the turbine always exposed by stronger wind. These HAWT wind turbine are more traditional windmill type of turbines that look like a large propeller at the top of the tower or pole. The term horizontal axis wind turbine, or HAWT, was named due to the axis of the rotating turbine are constructed in horizontal, which is parallel to the ground. This type was usually used in wind farm. Advantages of horizontal axis wind turbine are self-starting, has a tall tower to axis stronger wind, blade position on the center side for stability, can resist storm because a rotor will pitch. These advantages are difficult to maintain due to height. Turbine's difficulty to operate on ground wind needs stronger heavy construction due to very high tower requirements and proximity affects radar. Number 2, VEWT wind turbine, vertical axis wind turbine, are suitable on urban places and low-lying areas on where the wind direction is frequently changing or less predictable. This is a type of wind turbines on which the rotor installed vertically and rotate a shaft. The generator of this wind turbine can be found near ground for easy to reach during maintenance. We call a vertical axis because the rotating axis is aligned vertically facing upward. This vertical axis wind turbine is less common usage of people due to less efficient in power generation. The advantages of using vertical axis wind turbine are always effective operation on any place to be installed. Low construction cost and wind generator is easy to maintain. The disadvantages of VEWT is less efficient of producing power than horizontal axis wind turbine. Construction and characteristics of horizontal axis wind turbine, HAWT, are the following. Number 1, HAWT produced 20% to 40% more electrical power output and more energy output at normal wind speed than vertical axis wind turbine. Number 2. Construction requires only less ground space. Number 3. Have integrated system to shut off during high wind speed to avoid damage of turbine components. This HAWT can operate also in worst wind condition due to a special system construction. Number 4. This HAWT was constructed with built-in wind vane and yaw mechanism for automatic directional movement of the turbine blade to always face the wind direction for rotor rotation. Number 5. Even the maintenance of the machine components is not so accessible, but still it is constructed to higher position so that it can catch a stronger winds. The two basic types of horizontal axis wind turbine, HAWT. Number 1. Upwind horizontal axis wind turbine. A type of wind turbine on which rotor always faces on the wind direction, while the turbine generator components are behind the turbine rotor. This type of turbine are commonly used for any wind farm because the rotor will not affected from the windshield of tower and generator component. The rotor blades of these upwind turbines are strong heavier metal and cannot bend to avoid collision in the tower or mast during high wind speed. The upwind turbine require also yawing mechanism that adds more heavier weight of turbine structure, but this type of wind turbines give more efficient operation with less wear and tear of rotors. Number 2. Downwind horizontal axis wind turbine. This is similar look to upwind horizontal axis wind turbine. The only difference is the rotor location was on downstream position of the tower. This downwind type is not require any yaw mechanism because the rotor are designed to be follow on wind direction. It is not common type that people use due to windshield effect efficiency. The rotor is located behind downstream of the mast and tower, on which affected with wind shear or wind flow block disturbance. From this downwind turbine design, create fluctuation from amount of power to be generated due to wind shear effect. This wind shear effect can result more fatigue of downwind type rotor. The downwind turbine are lighter structural weight, flexible rotor blades, and better dynamic structure of tower, in which rotor blade bended away from tower. Types of vertical axis wind turbine, VAWT. Number 1. Savonius turbine. This type of wind turbines cannot produce more electrical energy on the generator due to the low RPM on high torque generation during self-starting. This type of wind turbine is good only for small power application, but not good in large amount of power generation. The design is highly inefficient because the rotation is not high speed. The Savonius turbine is similar to cup anemometers on which cup always facing to wind direction, while the back of the cup is round shape, creating a drag adverse force to lower the speed of rotation. The design is simple that require a little maintenance and very useful for low power application like water pumps, cooling fans, grinding grains, and other low power tasks. This is also very good working on low speed wind and work well even in turbulent wind direction. The best example of Savonius turbine is anemometers that measure only wind speed. The force of Savonius turbines that makes rotation is drag, or known a drag type VAWT or vertical axis wind turbine. Number 2. Darius wind turbine. A type of vertical axis wind turbine on which named and patented by a French engineer, George Darius, in year 1931. This is a lift type VEWT, or vertical axis wind turbine, has a curved blade like C shape connected to generator shaft that generate more power and good efficiency due to high speed rotation. The Darius blade is like a shape of the airplane wings on which wind pass on the blade that create an aero fuel effect lifting to rotate the wind turbine. The aero fuel blades of this type of turbine can also be helical in shape, straight, and curved. The Darius turbine rotor blade have similar lifting principle, even it was created on different form. This type is widely used for power generation. Even the higher speed rotation create a lower torque level and also not self-starting. Number 3. Gyromill wind turbines. Is also not self-starting and speed rotation is not steady, that cost not so efficient than Darius wind turbine. But it is cheap and still can work in turbulent wind. Number 4. Cycloturbines is a hybrid type of VEWT, or vertical axis wind turbine, on which the air fuel blades are variable pitch type and almost similar to gyromill wind turbines. The cycloturbines blade pitch against the wind like Savonius to produce drag and torque for self-starting until it reaches to a specific RPM, revolution per minute. Then the pitch changes on similar way to Darius that produce more lift and more reach on higher speed rotation. This type of turbine is efficient and flexible, VEWT, or vertical axis wind turbine, even it is heavier design and more components required for maintenance. Other design of wind turbine. Number 1. Ducted wind turbines. Is a small type of wind turbine that installed on the edge of some building to catch upward air flows. This turbine is not popular due to limited airflow of building side. Number 2. Cooling tower updraft turbine. This turbine is configured in Darius vertical axis wind turbine and installed at the top of the tower. The turbine drives by updraft creation of exhaust airflow. Number 3. Diffuser augmented wind turbine. Is a cone-shaped wind diffuser on which rotor blades are installed within the diffuser. This diffuser helps to increase the rotation speed of rotor. Some modification of the diffuser can be done to increase the efficiency of generating wind power to electricity. The rotor blades can also mounted vertically on shaft support. Number 4. Vehicle powered wind turbine. It is installed on central location of the highways or freeways, on which a high speed passing vehicles create wind turbulence to rotate the turbine. This type is a conventional vertical axis wind turbine that not only driven by a natural wind but driven also by constant stream of wind turbulence from vehicle speed. Number 5. Twin-bladed rotor wind turbine was manufactured by Nordic Wind Power Company. This is a two-bladed wind turbines like Groywon that experimented in Germany from year 1983 to 1987. Number 6. Wind 3 wind turbine. It is based on Savonius vertical axis wind turbine design that uses a group of small wind turbines arranged to look like a leaves of the tree for urban decoration. Number 7. Cross-axis wind turbine is combined design from two configurations of both vertical and horizontal blade that crosses each other. The efficiency was increased 2.5 times than conventional turbine. This design can capture the wind energy in both vertical and horizontal wind direction because of a 3 vertical blade and 6 horizontal blade cross-link configuration of the wind turbine. Number 8. Flapping panel wind turbine. It is a vertical axis wind turbine on which the blade are adjustable flaps. This type of turbine, also called check valve turbine. The flaps will close for restriction of wind to pass through the sail when wind is flowing and create wind block to allow the turbine start on rotation. Number 9. Vertex bladeless wind turbine. This type has no rotating blades that danger to any migrating birds. The design relies on wind vortices as opposed to a constant breeze. Bladeless wind turbine oscillate in response to wind vortices on resonant phenomenon that known as vortex-induced vibration. The system uses pillar shaped mast that extract wind energy using a vortex-induced resonance technique. It has fewer moving parts, but it is inefficient compared to other wind turbine design. Wind cause turbulence when it pass to pillar and create vibration to mechanical energy that can drive the linear alternator to generate an electricity. Number 10. Counter-rotating horizontal axis wind turbine is a combination of upwind and downwind horizontal axis wind turbine design that installed on same tower and do not need gearbox for alignment. These counter-rotating turbines can gain 40% more efficiency on capturing in downwind energy as a leftover energy from upwind turbine. This design is very interesting, even they are difficult to engineer due to the two rotors rotate against each other and passively align on the wind direction. Counter-rotating turbine has the ability to make auto-centering on the turbine and even without any gearbox provided in wind turbine system. The construction of this turbine is tricky because the downwind turbine must be smaller than upwind turbine and have a timing on rotational speed ratio to avoid vibration or structural failures. Number 11. Coaxial or multi-rotor wind turbine. This type of turbine have more than 3 rotors mounted on the drive shaft on which 10 to 20% increased power but less efficient than counter-rotating. Horizontal axis wind turbine is classified according to their rotor configuration. Number 1. Single blade wind turbine are used in few applications and have one or two counterbalance for smooth rotation. It rotates on high speed than two or three blade turbine in similar blade size. The bearing and mounting mechanism of this single blade wind turbine will easily damage due to a higher speed that causes a higher maintenance. Few of us using a single blade wind turbine because it requires an excellent setup of blade mounting to limit oscillation and vibration during rotation. Number 2. Two-blade wind turbine is safer and faster installation but still less efficient on wind energy conversion than three-blade wind turbine. This type of wind turbine have high fatigue on blade and other mechanical parts failure, which makes more noise operation than a three-blade wind turbine. Number 3. Three-blade wind turbine. This is most used design for wide range of power generation due to the good balance of three rotor and create less noise or vibration. This type of wind turbines gives more energy conversion because the three-blade can provide more wind capture of wind energy into electrical energy than a single blade or two blade wind turbine. Number 4. Multi-blade wind turbine have less strength of construction material because it is thinner blades and narrow. They are excellent in low speed wind blow but not too efficient on high wind speed. The multi-blade turbine can create more noise because it consists of curved sheet metal with inner and outer end that fix on rims. Vertical axis wind turbine have also two rotor configuration like Savonius type and Darius type that was already explained before. Generators of wind turbine and their function. One of the main components of creating electrical energy on wind turbine is generator. Wind turbines create electrical energy by using wind power to rotate the electric generator. The wind turbine have two types in terms of speed characteristics. Number 1. Fixed speed wind turbine. This is most common type of which the induction generator have direct connection to the grid system that result a flaws due to a control failure on grid voltage. Number 2. Variable speed wind turbines. This turbine have installed electronic converter to avoid flaws. The turbine becomes stable on the dynamic behavior and reduce noise at speed due to electronic. Mostly, a generator can be run on fixed speed or variable speed, but the ideal operation of the wind turbine generator is variable speed that compensate a dynamic nature of wind power. Wind turbine generator reduce the physical stress of turbine drive and bleed. Wind operated on variable speed. It is also improve the transient torque behavior and aerodynamic system efficiency. Wind turbines have four types of generator that attach on the system. Number 1. AC synchronous generator. A wind turbine generator that have a rotor and magnetic files on stator. These generators also known as PMSG, Permanent Magnet Synchronous Generator, or EESG, Electrical Excited Synchronous Generator. Their DC excitation are permanent magnet or electromagnetic. EC Synchronous Generator produce three-phase power from the stator winding that are connected to the electrical grid through transformer and power converter when the wind turbine drives the rotor. The power converter operates the AC power containing variable frequency while magnitude is rectified first into fixed DC and finally converted again into AC power. The reason why this electronic converter is used in the system because permanent magnet synchronous generator cannot produce electricity with fixed frequency due to a variable wind speed power. The advantage of this permanent magnet synchronous generator are simple, rugged, and reliable. It requires less maintenance because no slip rings, brushes, and commutator. The disadvantages of this PMSG are more costly, complicated, that require delicate operation, and prone to failure compared to induction generators. Number 2. Induction generator is also called EC asynchronous generator that most used in wind turbines. This generator was commonly used because it is cheap price compared to the synchronous generator. The asynchronous generator or induction generator have two types of classification, like DFIG or doubly feed induction generator and FSIG or fixed speed induction generator. Number 3. DC generator. A wind turbine generator that has brushes and commutator that need a regular maintenance. The maintenance is relatively costly because DC wind generator system has plenty equipment used, like IGBT, insulated gate bipolar transistor inverter, controller, transformer, and power grid. The field current of the shunt wound DC generator increases with operational speed, while the balance of the wind turbine drive torque determines the actual speed of the turbine rotor. The electricity of this DC generator is extracted through brushes on which connected to the commutator during a generation of AC power and conversion of DC output. Number 4. SRG or switch reluctance generator is usually used in wind power plant due to their ability on variable speed range operation. This type of wind turbine generator is also simple, easy to manufacture, and assemble because the rotor is only built on laminated steel sheet without field winding or permanent magnet. Wind turbines have three applications based on their location and type of connection. Number 1. Offshore wind turbines are capturing the powerful ocean winds that generate a huge amount of energy. Offshore wind power includes inshore water areas like sheltered coastal areas, lakes, and deep water areas. The disadvantage of offshore installation is more expensive and higher maintenance cost. The offshore wind turbines exposed to high humidity of salt water, causing to corrosion and oxidation. Air conditioning on the sealed nacelle is the one to control the temperature and humidity to avoid equipment corrosion. Cathodic protection and epoxy coating applied on tower to reduce corrosion. Number 2. Land-based wind turbine are also larger wind turbines that range from 100 kilowatts to megawatts. These wind turbines are grouped together in wind plant in order to give a bulk electrical power. Land-based wind turbine is cheaper installation and low maintenance cost than offshore wind turbine. But the installation of land-based wind turbine can destroy physical environment and habitat. Number 3. Distributed wind turbine are small wind turbines below 100 kilowatts that installed near the place where produced energy was used directly on consumer like agriculture and residential. Some residential, small commercial or industrial application uses small turbine as hybrid energy system by combining the other energy sources like diesel generators, photovoltaics, and batteries. A residential distributed wind is small wind turbine connected to residential net metering on which not used wind turbine electricity flow back on electrical grid system. The advantage of using distributed wind generation are you can sell not used power back to electrical grid company, less cost for installation or shipment, and independent power if using batteries. History of wind turbine creation. During 1080 to 1780, the hero of Alexandra windmill is one of the first recorded for wind powering machine in history. In 7th century, the first practical wind power plant was built in Sistan at east part of Iran. On year 1190, German crusaders taking their windmill creation skills to Syria. Year 1595, the Croatian inventor Fausto Virancio described the advanced vertical axis wind turbine with V-shaped or curved blades on his Machine Novi book. July 1887, the Scottish academic James Blyth installed the first electric generation wind turbine with battery charging machine to light his holiday home in Mariekirk, Scotland. Year 1900. Denmark have 2,500 windmills for mechanical loads, for mills and pumps, producing about 30 megawatts combined peak power. Year 1908. A 72 wind-driven electric generators producing 5 kilowatt to 25 kilowatt was operated in United States. On year 1930s, wind generator for electricity was installed mostly in United States on farm, but no distribution system because it is placed only on top of prefabricated open steel lattice tower. Year 1931, a modern tower horizontal axis wind generators was used at Valta, USSR. Year 1941. A first megawatt class wind turbine was synchronized to a utility grid system in Vermont. Year 1951. John Brown and Company built the first utility grid connected wind turbine at Orkney Island, UK. In year 1970s, anti-nuclear protest in Denmark from propelled artisan mechanics to develop a 22 kilowatt micro turbines. Year 1980s, provide incentives for larger turbines on which turbine owners organized into association or cooperatives lead to lobbying on government and utilities. Year on early 1990s, a large investor in United States, local activist in Germany, and nascent turbine manufacturers in Spain lobbied for policies to motivate the industry from their country. Year 2004. First wind farm was installed and commissioned in Southeast Asia, Baguio, Ilocos Norte on the northern end of Luzon Island, Philippines. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, follow, and good comments.